Harry was one of the best, and he is a legend.
Harry Potter is one of a kind. He's the sort of journalist, when he was out on the road, he would be remembered and respected by everyone he came into contact with, whether it be cops, crooks, or lawyers. Even to this day, I get cops coming up to me saying, oh, how's H going? Where's H? What's H up to?
Harry was the type of guy who was the true newspaper journalist. And then he went into television. And he just walked straight into that. He was a natural. There are many funny stories. A lot of the stories, I would say, not for press.
He's set such a fine example for so many people. He's mentored young reporters. And just by watching Harry operate, you can learn a hell of a lot.
And if you happen to be done in a story, as we call it, or you're not having a good run in the game, just hang on, because when you can miss getting a video, or you feel you've been scooped one day, but within a day or two you could have the story of the year.
He likes to talk. He tells a good story. Even now we can be out driving anywhere, whether it's Sydney or even the back of New South Wales, for example, and there might be a beautiful landscape or a beautiful coastal scene, and Harry will say, that looks just like the place where Ivan Milat committed those terrible, gruesome murders. I remember that in detail. And you get the whole story all over again.
The serial killer would have driven into the forest with his victims late afternoon. As nightfall approaches here, an eerie chill hangs over the forest.
Even when he wasn't getting what he was after, he was still a gentleman. I think he saw that as the way of, I'll coax it out of them by being nice.
A lot of people Dad did stories on here. He'd sit there at night and check on and call them up 2, 3, 10, 20 years later, probably more. We're just so grateful that everyone is honouring him in this way, and especially because it's an industry that Dad loves so much.
The story that really sticks out in my mind is from the early 90s, when the early bird was always catching the worm. At about 6 o'clock in the morning, this is decades before Facebook, I've walked out with a photo. And as I was walking out the front gate, Harry was walking in. He saw that I had the photo. He looked me straight in the eye and said, Adam, I'd do the same for you, pal. And he would, so I handed it over.
We miss you out on the road, mate. But, let's hope it won't be long, and we'll see a guest appearance by the Silver Fox. Take it easy, buddy.